of Mary. This is Auntie Alice writing you a letter, January 15th, 1994. I am writing this letter to you to let you know a little bit about the Krzyżanowski and the Tatko family. First of all, Grandpa Krzyżanowski, Victor I, was born in Buffalo, New York, in the year of 1897. And Grandma was born in Poland in the year 1904 and brought to Canada by Grandma and Grandpa Tatko when she was only 10 months old. They first went to Grimsby. Grandma was the baby of the family. Then it was Uncle Kashmir, Uncle Frank, Uncle Leo, Uncle Stanley, Uncle Julius, Aunt Mary, and Uncle John. That was Grandma's oldest brother. I think there were 8 children altogether. Grandma Tatko, her name was Joanna, that's Joanne in English. They went to Grimsby, where they were brought up on a farm with cabins. And they, as young little boys, and Grandma was just a little tiny girl. She was only 10 months old when she got there. She worked for 5 cents a day. They used to pick cherries, peaches, apples, anything that grew. There was a canning factory, and the boys all worked on that. And any money that they made, they gave to Grandma and Grandpa Tatko. Then when Grandma got a little bit older, they moved to St. Catharines, Ontario in Canada, and there Grandma Tatko bought a house, and they built a little church. It was called St. Joseph's, and that's where Grandma was brought up with the boys. She went to school there. She was a very bright young girl and a young woman. She was wonderful in math and spelling and reading, which that's what they mostly thought in those years. Grandma could count numbers like an adding machine. She was a very bright, considered almost a genius. And she could get a letter in English and read it back in Polish. She was a very, very bright woman. People used to come to her that used to get letters from Poland, and they couldn't read it, so Grandma would read it to them in English, and it was written in Polish. She could play the piano beautiful. She was a very bright young woman. And then, while growing up in Canada, your grandfather, Victor I, went to visit somebody in Canada, and that's where he met Grandma. Then they came back to Buffalo, and they got married June the 1st in 1925. They lived, I think, on Moore Avenue. No, first on Lydell Street, where I was born March 30th, 1926. And I was, they were both married in St. John County Church. It was right in the neighborhood. Grandma and Grandpa were married there June the 1st. Then I was born a year later. I was baptized there. I was also made my first Holy Communion there, and I stayed till the 4th grade. And Grandma had your father, Victor II, on September the 29th, 1929. And he was born on Moore Avenue. And then as he was a little boy, we were just, growing up, they moved on North Central, which is up a Broadway not far from Bailey. And there, we used to live there until I finished the 4th grade, which was, I was about 10 years old. Then we moved on Stanley Street, where we went to visitation school, East Lovejoy. We lived in a beautiful 4-bedroom, bedroom house. We had a big bathroom with a tile floor and a bathtub, and which many people didn't have in those years. Then with four big bedrooms, and downstairs was a kitchen and the most beautiful dining room, living room, and a reception room where Grandma had her piano. And she used to play it. It was the most beautiful house that you could ever find. And they had a veranda, and when we were little kids, well, your father was smaller than me, and I used to play with the kids. We'd go to the store, we'd go to the show. It was a little wooden show with wooden steps, and it was just beautiful living in that neighborhood. And then Grandma moved from there, and Grandpa, they moved on Sycamore Street, 1075 Sycamore, which wasn't pretty at all, but it was nice. And we lived upstairs over a butcher shop. And I went to school 58. I graduated from there. And then your father was going to Transfiguration School, and he graduated from there. It was close to going to Sackler's and the Broadway Market, and that was around Fillmore Avenue. It was nice, but it wasn't as nice as Stanley Street. Almost all my happy memories were of Stanley Street, going to Hennepin Park and just having a real good time. And Babcia Tatka would come along with Grandma. She lived with us. She was a beautiful woman and a very kind person. She taught us a lot about God, about life, and how to love people. She was a wonderful, wonderful person, and we loved her very much. And after we lived on Sycamore Street, I think I was 14 when we moved on Waltz Avenue, which wasn't that far. So we lived on Waltz Avenue for about 3 or 4 years. And then that was okay too. It was a nice apartment. It was near Humble Park. Your dad and I and Auntie Vicky and Auntie Celia and Uncle Richie and Uncle Henry and Uncle Cupid, we all used to go to Humble Park and go on a toboggan there. We'd go ice skating. It was just simply beautiful. Nobody was afraid to leave the house. It was very, very nice. And then then when I was 15 years old, I got very, very sick. And I was taken to the hospital, and they diagnosed me as having diabetes. So then I had to start taking insulin and everything. And then Grandma moved to on Paderewski Drive, on 184 Paderewski. And that's where she lived with Babcia. And Uncle Leo had his barber shop downstairs. And Auntie Pearl lived in the back with her boys, Leo, Henry, Cupek, which was Eddie, and Uncle Richie. And they lived over there. He had his barber shop, and next door there was a little candy store, which was very nice. We had a little dog, and we used to call her Beauty. She was a nice little, like a Pomeranian dog. And while living over there, I used to go to the dances, which were very popular at the time, with your father. He was much younger though, so he wasn't really interested in that, so then he didn't go anymore. But I used to go with, I had girlfriends I used to go with, and one of them was Auntie Vicky. We used to go to Peter and Paul dancing, we went to Dombowski dancing, St. John Canty, and it was very nice. And that's where I met Uncle Eddie, and we were married in 1946, June the 15th, 1946. And then I went to live on Peckham Street with him. But in the meantime, your dad met your mother, Frances Stempien. She was a very beautiful young lady. She had the heart of gold. And your dad, when he met her, that's all he wanted in his life was her. So they were married in the year 1955, in June, and we were all at the wedding. He had it at St. Stan's. The you know, the reception, and they were married. I believe it was that church or Corpus Christi. I don't remember, but they were married, and I had already had Audrey. She was born April 4th, 1952. And then Joey was born January 9th, 1956. I was pregnant with Joey when your mother got married. And that's where I met your Aunt Seal and Uncle Hank. They had, I believe they just had Kathy at the time. And that's where I met your Aunt Ronnie. She had a bunch of kids too. And your Uncle John. And he, oh, him and Mary, they, she, your Aunt Mary was always pregnant. She, I don't know, she had quite a few children. I can't remember their names. And then there was Uncle Hank and Aunt Carol. They had a few children. And, but I do not remember your Uncle Tony. He lived in California. So when your mother and father were married in June, then they had Michael in April, and I was Michael's grandmother, and your Uncle John was the godfather of him. Then I think about a year or so later, they had John, and I remember his godfather was Uncle Richie. I don't remember who the godmother was. And then they had Victor, and then after Victor, they had you. And they had James and Daniel and then Joseph. And Joseph was born, I forget what, I think 1970, because you were born in 1960. And when he was born in 1970, Audrey was his godmother. She was only 18 years old then. That's my daughter, Audrey Ann. And then after that, oh, I would say, maybe 6 years later, in 1976, your mom passed away with breast cancer. She was a beautiful person. She was very, very kind and very generous. She used to pick up all the kids in a big old station wagon and with her dog Lucky, and off they'd go to the parks, and she would show the children a beautiful, beautiful time. She was a very good person. And so was your father. Your father worked very hard by Loblaws in the warehouse, Peter J. Schmidt. And then when your mom passed away, well, they first, they bought that house on Theodore, which to them was a beautiful house because the church was right behind it. The school was there. You didn't have far to go to school. You didn't have to go far. There was a Tops Market. There was the Belt Supermarket, there was Leon's, the Butcher Shop, Pine Hill Butcher Shop, the Danny Galuski's Barber Shop was there. On a corner, your mother had the drugstore. There was a photographic studio on Theodore. Then there was a hardware store, there was a liquor store, and Schiller Park was just around the corner, which was beautiful. And the kids were always in the park. You really, really had it nice over there. Your mom and dad did everything they could to make you kids happy and to make it convenient for you so you wouldn't have to go far to school or to the park or anywhere. And then when your mom passed away, your father just kept on living there. And in the meantime, Michael and the kids were going to school. Michael graduated from Queen of Peace, and he went to Bishop, no, not to Bishop, he went to Kensington. And John went to Queen of Peace, and then Victor graduated from Queen of Peace, and he went to Bishop Turner, and that's where he graduated from. And then after that, you went to Queen of Peace. Then you went to school 11, and as I remember, you went to Villa Maria High School, Villa Maria Academy. Then you went to Villa Maria College for 2 years. You went to ECC downtown for 2 years, and I believe you went 1 year to the state in Buffalo. And you used to take the bus. You were a wonderful, wonderful child, Mary. You stayed with me a lot, but your true home was your mother's and father's home. And then, after that, Jimmy graduated from Queen of Peace, and then he had to go to Bishop Turner High School. He was a very, very bright student, very, very smart. And then it was Danny was born. Danny was born with cerebral palsy, and he's in that home on South Elmwood. I believe he's about 24, 25 years old now. I'm not sure, but he's well taken care of over there. And I feel that you should all go and see him one of these days. When Michael comes to Buffalo, and John and Jimmy and Joey, you should all go and see him because he is your brother. And then Joey graduated from Queen of Peace. He was very, very bright and a very, very bright student and very, very nice. He never got into trouble. He was a wonderful young man, and he graduated from Bishop Turner. And then, after he graduated from Bishop Turner, he went to Buff State. And he graduated from Buff State, stayed home for a while, worked in Tops Market. And then he went to work for Oscar's, where they sell pop and beer and everything. And while working over there, he met Laura. And they got together, but he still stayed in Buffalo. She stayed in Buffalo for a while, then she moved to Maryland or Virginia or someplace near Washington, D.C., where her parents are. And in the meantime, I'm getting a little bit ahead of my story, but in the meantime, Michael got married with Sheila Hayes. They were married, I believe, in 1981. And then they had a little girl, and her name was Audrey Ann Krzyzanowski. Then they had Eric, I believe in 1988. Now, I'm not sure, but I think so. And he was born in August or September. I believe in September, yeah. And then Leanna was born to them in July. The two girls were born in July, and Eric was born in September. Three beautiful children. Sheila was a beautiful mother and a very good mother, and Michael was the perfect father. He took good care of the kids, and he's still taking good care of them. He's working. He worked himself up. They have a beautiful home in near Rochester, and two dogs. I think, I can't always remember their names, but I know one is Bear, and I forget what the other one is, but anyway, he's a beautiful dog. And Norman lives with them too. He was a friend of the family since he was a little boy. And so Michael and Norman are the odd couple. And then there is John. He got married to Mary, who also is from Rochester. He's doing very, very well. He's got a beautiful home, and his wife is wonderful. I love Mary. She's a good mother, and John's a wonderful father. And they have two little girls. One is Elizabeth, and the other one is Rachel. They're beautiful little girls. So we go to their house mostly when it's their birthdays. Elizabeth is 3 years old now, and Rachel is one. They're beautiful, beautiful, bright little girls. James never got married, but I'm sure he gets around. He's got a beautiful job in Indiana. He's a very, very bright man. I think he takes after Grandma Josephine. And because she was so bright with everything, especially with math. And he sort of reminds me of her and sort of your Uncle John, Stampy, because he's bright with numbers like that too. I think they're in computers, him and Joey. Joey got a nice job in Maryland. Well, he lives in Maryland, but I believe the job is someplace in Washington, D.C. And he's got a really nice job. And I don't know what else to tell you, Mary, but I think you're doing a good job with your life. You're driving a car. You got a nice job, a good job in Tops Market. And in Tops Market, you're a cashier over there behind the desk. You cash checks and you sell lotto numbers. And hopefully, I wish you buy subs and win. And win a couple million so you could help the whole family out. And as far as your cousins go, Audrey and Dave Canizaro in 1977, May 1977, yeah. And she had a beautiful wedding at the Prime Rib on Transit Road, and they're very, very happy. They love each other. She's good to Dick, and he's good to her. They own a beautiful home on 207 Anderson Place off of Elmwood. And she's the one that took over making the vigilia for Christmas, a day before Christmas, where we all join together and have our meal. Michael, Sheila, the children, John, Mary, and the children, and you, Mary, you all come, and Joey and James, you all come to Audrey's house and we have a beautiful meal. She usually makes galumpi because she knows John likes them. And she makes enough of them to make sure he can take some home. And she has fresh Polish sausage, and she has the smoked Polish sausage. She has a ham. She has the sauerkraut pierogi. She has the cheese pierogi with the sour cream. And she has all kind of cheeses and chips and nuts and whatever you want to for pickings. And the good rye bread, and she makes mushroom soup, and we have wine. Michael always says grace. I'm so proud of Michael that he turned to be such a wonderful, good young man and a good father, which means wonderful for the children. And like I always told Michael, that you should always have music in the house, no matter what kind of music, as long as it's music. Play it, always have music, be happy. Have love for the children and love in your heart for everybody. And don't forget God, because God is number one. So I think Michael has all that. The love, the music, and books. Always read, because reading a book is wonderful. It doesn't matter. You can read a newspaper or even a comic book, or you can read Agatha Christie. No matter what you read, it's reading, and that's what makes your mind strong and bright. And you should always, always keep that in mind. That's my advice to you. And then Joey, my son Joey, we call him Joey. He works at the Galleria Mall. He's on Mall Patrol over there. He's your cousin, but I think he's more like a brother than a cousin. We were all brought up together. We were a very close-knit family when we lived on Crossman and your mom and dad lived on Theater Street, which was maybe a 5-minute walk. And then you have cousins. I can't remember the family so much, but your Aunt Ciel, she loves you very much. She's the one that's married to Henry Szymański. And they have two daughters, Kathy and Karen. And you should always think about your Aunt Seal, because that was your mother's sister, and your Aunt Ronnie. Your Aunt Ronnie's real name is Sophie Stampin, but she I don't think she cared for the name, so she called herself Ronnie. And that's about all that I can tell you about that, about the Stampin family. I don't know that much about it. But I remember your mother driving the car, and she had all these kids in that car. not only you kids, but she also picked kids from the neighborhood, and she had them in that car. And you'd all go. It was called Henry's. It was a hamburger place on Bailey and Genesee Street. It's a McDonald's now, but it used to be called Henry's. And they used to sell 10-cent hamburgers over there, which are absolutely delicious. And she used to buy those hamburgers for the kids and the milkshakes. But she would get one milkshake, and she would give everybody a drink from that milkshake. And the hamburger, too, she'd break off. She'd put a piece in Michael's mouth. She'd break off a piece for John. She'd break off a piece for Victor. She took a piece for you, a piece for Joey, and for Jimmy. It was really, really cute the way she used to do that. And then once she passed one hamburger on, then she went and got another hamburger. Until you ate it all and you were all full, then she'd take off and go to some park, and mostly in Pembroke, because that's where your mother was brought up, around Pembroke in I think Oakfield. It was both your grandparents from the Stampion family were married out in Oakfield, I think, St. Mary's Church, but I'm not sure. And so your mom was brought up on a farm. She used to ride the bike, and she was very bright also. And then there was your Uncle Hank, who was, I think, younger than your mother. Oh, and Uncle Teddy. And when your mother moved, and your Uncle Teddy came to live in Buffalo, and he worked for Lippy's Bakery, and he lived with your mom and dad on the third floor on Theater Street until he moved out after your mom passed away. And I don't know what else to tell you, Mary. But I know that you had two dogs, and their names were Butchie and Brownie. And then when your mom passed away, they lived for a while, but they all got cold. They got very arthritic. They were very funny dogs. They were very comical. Brownie used to chase the cars, and he'd go across the street, and if the guy had his window open to the car, he'd jump through the window and he'd sit behind the wheel like he was driving it. He loved to be in a car. Butchie wasn't let out much because he used to like to snap at people, so your mom or less kept him in the backyard on a chain. But when they got too arthritic and too old, they had to be put to sleep, and Mary, you're the one that took him to be put to sleep. Then Sheila gave you a dog by the name of Lucky, the other dog is with Pepper? I think so. Well, anyway, you have two dogs, a male and a female, but they're both fixed, and you take wonderful, wonderful care of them, Mary. You're a very good person. Plus, you have two little cats where Uncle Ted used to stay, so that's very nice. And little by little, hopefully, I hope you can straighten the house out, fix it up and sell it, and maybe get yourself a pretty little house in Cheektowaga someplace. Maybe one of your brothers could help you, because they only have one sister, and I know they all love you. You're a very close-knit family. I wish Jimmy could get a job in Buffalo, so he could buy a house in Cheektowaga, so you could live there with him. Maybe a two-family house, and then we'd all be together again. And we could always just jump in the car and go visit Michael and John. It's not too long of a drive, about hour and a half to 2 hours. I think Joey likes to live in Maryland and with Laura. I think that's wonderful. But I wish he wouldn't hate Buffalo. He should just say, I don't like living there. But he shouldn't say, I hate it, because that's where he was brought up. He was born here. He was baptized, confirmed. He made his Holy Communion. And he had a good education in Buffalo. And he had a happy life here. He went to one of the best high schools in Buffalo, Bishop Turner. Him and Jimmy went over there. And Michael graduated from Kensington. I really don't know where John went to school. Maybe he went to Kensington too, but I'm not sure. Because I was working at the time. I worked as a dining room hostess at the Hallmark Manor on Main Street, and I can use this letter on this side. After I worked at the Hallmark Manor as a dining room hostess, I went to work at the Cloud Room at the Buffalo Airport, which was a beautiful, beautiful job. But I was never home with the children, so I moved my job over to QRS Piano Rolls Incorporated, which was a nice job because I went to work at 8 and was home by 5. And in the meantime, as I was working, Grandma was living with me, and she took care of Audrey and Joey while I was working. Because Joey was only in grammar school, and then and so was Audrey. But in the meantime, she took care of them very well. I loved Grandma very much. She was a dear, sweet person. And I wanted to tell you something a little bit about your brother Victor. Victor was so handsome. He had the most beautiful blonde hair, and the girls were just crazy about him. He used to come to my house to do the laundry. And then he'd be doing things. I asked him to clean my gutters. He cleaned them. I asked him to cut grass. He'd cut the grass. And he never wanted anything for it. He was so nice. How I loved Victor. So what a tragic thing it was that he died in 1977. He was such a wonderful, wonderful young man. But God wanted him, and he took him. And I just wanted to tell you something, Mary, that when you were a little girl, you used to love to play with Barbie dolls, and used to go out with Sam and with Mary Schroeder. Now they're both married. I think Mary's got 3 children, and Sam has 2 little girls, which is very nice. And I really don't know yet what to tell you, Mary. But anyway, I want to tell you that I love you and Michael, John and Mary and their children, and Michael and his children, Jimmy, Joey, you, Danny. I love you very much. You're like my own children. I have this strong feeling for all of you. And I love you very much because your mother and father were very good to me, too. We were very, very close. And as far as you working, Mary, I wish you could, even though Tops is a nice job, I wish you could get a job in some bank or someplace. Because I want you to make so much money. Because I want you to come and live in Chicago. So, anyway, I'm going to sign off now and tell you that I love you and I love you kids. And, come and see me more often, okay? And so I'm going to sign up and say goodbye. I love you all, and I wish you the best of luck. More than anything, good health, and have a prosperous life and a happy life. And that's what counts in life. So I love you all, so I'm going to sign up and say goodbye.